Welcome to Explified. Today's topic is on how to make your mark in group discussions. Group discussions are an essential part of the screening process in most exams and interviews. A lot of weightage is put on how a candidate reacts and behaves to information gathered in real time, as this is an integral part of determining how suited he or she is for a particular position. Performance in group discussions are indicative of the soft skill set possessed by an individual and assesses their ability to deal with topics which they might not be fully conversant with, delivered on the spot. It judges a candidate's communication skills and team building ability. Therefore, it is very important to do well in group discussions. There are no specific rules or hacks on how to prepare for them, but here is a list of useful pointers which might come in handy. Keep yourself thoroughly updated with current affairs. There's a very high probability of being offered a topic which requires an extensive knowledge of the world around you. Reading newspapers daily and watching debates on television will help you get there. It doesn't hurt to have a good general knowledge. I would suggest buying a yearbook and taking quizzes on various GK websites. Follow good content on the internet. There's plenty of it. Reading an article a day from an informative website like Wikipedia or thought.co will help you get that extra edge. That's about it for the preliminary preparation. But knowing and performing are two entirely different things. When the topic is given, use the time allotted very preciously. It is advisable to immediately jot down points and possible rebuttals. In case of a doubt, total clarification is of utmost importance. Communicate your arguments in a crisp, simple manner, using flowery language or trying to show off by deliberating stating obscure facts which have no relation to the discussion is a strict no-no. Using proper references and citations is deemed as respectful and goes a long way. Try to take the lead in the conversation by steering questions and making sure every person and every perspective gets a chance to be heard out. This asserts your position as a potential leader in front of the panel. However, do remember that everyone in the room will have the same idea. In that case, trying to upstage someone forcefully can have terrible consequences. In case you have a rebuttal to make, follow a be nice, be respectful policy. It's not about proving someone wrong, it's about how you do it. Don't take anything personally. This is a group discussion, not a casual banter by a roadside tea stall. Adopt a pragmatic approach. Even if you don't personally agree with someone, but realize that doing so will help you cause, don't hesitate to compromise. Remember, volume is not a substitute for quality. Refrain from raising your voice to make a point. Even if others around you are shouting, try to put your points through in a calm, composed manner. It has a positive impression on the panel and displays composure under duress. Last but not the least, always try to steer the conversation in such a way that you are the one who puts in a conclusion. Concluding the discussion efficiently shows that you were listening to what the others have been saying and not just planning your own move about what to say next. It is very important to stay calm throughout the entire process. Keeping these tips in mind and following these diligently already puts you in an advantage. Thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe to Explified.